Okay, so in the last part, we started Dire Docks, and then it turned out that we had to fight Bowser in order to continue through Dire Docks, and I totally forgot about that. So in this part, we're gonna wrap up World 9, Course 9, whatever, and then we can move on to Course 10, which is actually in one of the top floors. There's two top floors. As you probably know, I think, was it 10 through 13 are upstairs, and then there's two more courses on, like, the very top floor. Well, not very, because the final Bowser boss fight is in, like, the top floor. But, anyway, let's start this one here. Now, this is the one that I got kind of confused in. Pole jumping for. Was it pole jumping? Yeah, for red coins. Now that Bowser's sub is gone, we're gonna see that in a moment, we can actually see the poles and actually grab red coins. Didn't seem. It. Yeah, I don't think it's possible to grab the red coins without the poles. If there is, there's probably some really weird way to grab them. But yeah, I think I said it in the last part, but this star is kind of tricky because of what you have to do. We'll see what happens. Okay, so alright. The sub is gone. It's completely gone. There's like no trace of it whatsoever. That hole there in the water, I don't know how visible it is it's gonna be on YouTube, but if you go through that, it brings you to the castle moat, which you don't want to go in. Unless you're trying to do like a fast exit. But, we're gonna start by hitting the switch here and working our way up to where the poles are. Oh, jeez, I couldn't get up there. Oh, yeah, if you've noticed, there's a vanish cap and a metal cap. You're actually going to be using both of those. Oh, maybe it's easier to go over there. I should probably just wait till this runs out then. But you're actually going to use both of those for, I think, the last star of this one? Not including the 100 coin star. Which, again, is going to be a pain in the butt because you have to go through a lot to get that too. Actually, you basically have to go through this again to get that star. Almost slid off there. Okay, and that's the end of the line for this pole, so I actually have to go to where I was trying to go in the first place. I'm actually really looking forward to it. Like, I never really liked Dire Docks that much, but I'm really looking forward to getting to, oh jeez. I have to jump to that a different way because it's not working. I think, Course 10, I know Snowman's Land. I think it's Course 11, which is Wet Dry World. That one's a fun one. And 12, I think, is Tall Town Mountain. That one, that one's gonna be a pain in the butt because I've never really been good at the certain stars in that course. Oh shoot, I forgot about that. All right, we're gonna have to jump to that pole over there. Yeah. Those stars that are behind like those cage things, those are the ones that I mean, not stars, the coins, red coins that are over there. Those are the ones that I have trouble getting. See, this part isn't that bad. Oh, okay, I almost didn't make it. Oh, these are just right here. Okay. This is, like, super important to grab if you're going for 100 coins. I could start that now, but I'm just gonna. That'll be its own thing. And okay, I have to travel back, I guess. This is a dead end. There we go. This Star, like I said, is kind of tedious. It's not one of my favorite missions in the game. The good thing is, like, if you, like, fall off, you don't, like, fall into an abyss or anything. You just fall into the water. You just have to do it over again. Transfer back. See, this is easier to see. Okay, I'm gonna wait for the pole over here. Oh, some of the other stars in here aren't really, I guess, time-consuming as this one. I'm looking at the ones down there, and there's, like, ones that are... They don't take that long at all. Okay, so for this one, I'm gonna grab this coin and then jump over to the pole on the other side. You have to be, like, really precise with your timing here. You have to basically wait till they intersect, like these two, or get close to each other. Timing is weird here. They're gonna meet eventually, though. I think right here. Oh, I made it. Cool. Okay, and after the last coin, it's gonna spawn over there. I guess, instead of waiting for, like, these poles to meet or whatever. Okay. Jeez. What was I? You need to go to that spot where the platform is, where the star is, and I think it's just easier to just do this. And right as I'm saying that, I fall in the water. Just awesome. Here we go. Yeah, like I said, the other stars in this course aren't really going to take as long as this one. Except for, like, the 100 coin star. I can do this all over again. Alrighty, so that was pole jumping for red coins. Oh, okay. It talks about the endless stairs. There's a staircase at the very top of the castle that's, like, endless if you don't have at least 70 stars. Through the jet stream. Oh, okay, this caught a glimpse of how you do this one. Not how you do it, but where it is. Anyway, there's, like, an endless staircase. It's actually possible to go through it, I think. But I've never tried to do it. It's kind of like you can go through it with, like, a glitch of some kind. I don't know what it is, but I like mute it or like edit it out, but whenever I record Mario 64, I have like burp fest. I don't like having them in the recordings, but that it happens. Anyway, this one here, I'm pretty sure you need the metal cap to get this. If not, then you could get it maybe by mashing the A button, but it's easier with the metal cap. You actually need to go through these rings. Can't tell if I'm going through them or not. Well, obviously not, but... Jeez, The water keeps pushing me away from the rings. There we go. Four. There we go. Okay, and the star spawns at the bottom there. It's kind of like in course 3, I think it was. Oh, shoot. I'm drowning. There we go. Located at the bottom of, like, a whirlpool. So, like I said, you might be able to get it without the metal cap, but I usually just grab it with it, because it's a lot easier. Okay, that is over here. Okay, I should be able to make it before this runs out. I should have jumped out into the water. Oh yeah, I can get this right here. Okay, so that's store 4, I think, of Dire Dire Docks. Right? Yep. Okay, star I can't remember. I think it's star 5, the manta ray one. Yeah. Okay, this one can be a pain in the butt sometimes too, but it's just like the previous one, you go through rings, but you have to follow this manta ray. If I remember right, he can hurt you, but if you stay kind of close to him, you can go through all the rings, and I just missed that last one. They're easier to go through if you're slightly far away from them, because they become, like, larger. But jeez, he keeps moving around. There we go. That's why I keep missing. But at least it seems like, I think they restore your air, so it's not that bad. Just one more, come on. There we go. Okay, now that's in a bit of a dangerous spot because it's right above the whirlpool. I don't want to get sucked in. Jeez. Come on. Like, all the sea life is watching me trying to grab this. Ooh, this is a school of fish. Oh! Okay. Oh, whoa! Crap. Okay. I think I'd swim out of it. I'm trying to get to these coins, though, because I don't want to drown. There we go. Yeah, I'm going to grab quite a few of these. These are important to grab for the 100 coin star as well. Right, now that I have a better angle, let's see if I can grab this easier. There we go. Here we go! And that was in slow motion too, when he grabbed it. Okay, the Manta Ray's reward, that one's done. And we just have two more. Oops. Now, star 6 is the one I talked about earlier, where you need the metal cap and the vanish cap. That's why it says collect the caps. I think this is the only instance in the game where you can get two caps at once. I always thought it'd be cool if you can, like, combine the caps, but like other caps, like the flying cap and the or the wing cap and the metal cap or whatever. I don't know what that would accomplish, but I think that would be pretty cool. But yeah, we're just going to make our way to the former submarine area. Okay, now, if you're paying close attention, this star, yeah, it's right there. We got that one. Well, you could see that one in the through the jet stream one. Okay, but I'm going to work my way up here and then grab the caps. I kind of wish some of these caps would appear in, like, other games. I don't think they've really appeared in most games after this one. I mean, they had, like, these were in the DS version, but they were, like, I mean, Mario couldn't grab all, like, they were designated to certain characters. I think Mario had the wing cap, Luigi had the vanish cap, and Wario had the metal cap. I hope I can make it over there. Okay, here we go. Oops. It's easier if you, like, jump up and grab it, because you don't have to swim to it, but, I got it anyway. Okay, that's star 6, and... Okay, if you notice, I got 54 coins in that one run when I wasn't really trying. And that was, like, the red coins and then those blue coins from that switch. So, hopefully this doesn't take too long. I am gonna try to grab a bunch of coins in this first part, though. Yeah, I'm gonna try to watch out for this whirlpool. Surprisingly, I haven't been, dragged into it yet. I've, come close, though. There we go. I always thought it was a cool touch that they put in, like, those small fish in here. In, not just in here, but in a bunch of water areas. Like, they don't even do anything, but it's just, like, cool that they've been added in. I think that was everything in here. Alright, next is, like, those coin rings. I think there's three of those. That gives you a bunch of coins if you get everything in this first part. Come on. There we go. Yeah, a lot of these water enemies, you can't really do anything to them. You just have to avoid them. There was, like, right there, the shark. I think that one's called Sushi. And then they have the orange fish. And the manta ray. Like I said, I think he can hurt you. He never hurt me in the previous star because... Was it the previous one? No, it wasn't the previous one. But one of the previous ones. Anyway, because I was trying to be careful. There we go. Yeah, most of them don't really pursue you. Like, at least in this course. There's that one, that big fat fish that eats Mario. He'll pursue you. And he'll try to eat you, and it's always annoying when he does that, too. But that's not until the tiny, huge island. I think that's what it's called. Okay, there's nothing over there. I forgot there's clams over here. Let's see if there's anything in here. Nope. And last one. There's a shell. Yeah, this really does not last very long. Yep, that was it. Pretty interesting, though, that in Super Mario Galaxy, and the second one, they brought that concept back with the shell. Like, in here, it just seemed like it was like a little bonus thing that you could do, because it didn't do anything. But in Galaxy, it's a little more fleshed out, because you can throw the shell, it has like a little light on it, and, you know, it works a lot better. Oh, shoot, you know what? I'm gonna wait for this to run out. I should go on the other part first over there. Okay, my record here is 54, so once I grab all the coins, I should be good. Yeah, it doesn't seem like there's a lot of coins to grab in this world. Like I said, a lot of the enemies you can't really hit, so they can't drop coins. But I guess that's why they have so many, like, coin rings. There was, like, a bunch of those. And then, like, lines of coins, stuff like that. Stray coins, I guess you could say. Alright. And, oh, end the line. I'm just gonna drop off here. Ah, I was hoping I'd land, like, near on that ramp. Alrighty, so... got, is it, 4 red coins, you need 4 more, and then the blue, oh wait, you know, I just realized, I'm gonna wait to grab those blue coins, because I've actually done this before. If you grab the last red coin, like, on the poles, I've actually got, the last red coin I got one time was the one on the other side of this, like, cage part. That was a pain in the butt to grab, because had to, like, time the jump right, and it was awkward. Definitely don't want that to happen again. Alright, but I gotta jump to the other pole again. Jeez. I think this turn right here, I think they're gonna intersect. There we go. Okay, and I'm just gonna jump off here. I have the one red coin that's on like the dead end part, and then the blue coins, and that should be it. I hope that's it, because I can't think of anywhere else that has coins. Okay. Oh, just in time. Alrighty. Oh! Okay. You know, I forgot about that jump, and then I just jumped there, and it was just way too late. Okay, I actually can hit the blue coin switch now, because that last red coin, I think it's on a platform, it's not floating in the air. Yeah, I could just grab that. There we go. And if that is... Oh wait. Oh no! Oh wait, okay, I do have to grab it. I still won't have enough though. Oh, okay, yeah. If my record was 54. Oh wait, no, wait, why didn't that. I must have grabbed some more coins that I didn't before. Where? I thought that would have been it. Okay, clams don't have anything. Something over here. I don't want to go near that part over there. Oh, shoot. I really thought I'd have all the coins by now. There's gotta be something that I missed over here. I wonder if these can drop anything. Nah, it's just a bunch of junk. I might swing back to the beginning. Because, I'm pretty sure I grabbed everything here. Yeah, this sucks. I just need 4 more. I think in my other file, the one, I've had since I've had the game, like the fully complete one, my record on that, I checked before this, was, 101, so... I mean, I know there's... Well, obviously it can be done, but... I could have swore that there were, I mean, that would be it once I grabbed the blue coins and the red coins. There's some coins up here. But yeah, I barely got over 100, so... That's cool, I didn't know he goes up to the surface like that. Alright, it doesn't seem like there's anything up here. Oh, wait, wait, wait. Ooh, okay. This line of coins should do it. There we go. Okay, so that... I actually totally forgot about these coins here. It's pretty interesting. Alright, well, we're done here, so let's get out. There we go. Alrighty, so... Yeah, I got exactly 100 there, but it doesn't really matter. So, courses 1 through 9 are done now. And in the next video, we're going to start with course 10, which is Snowman's Land. That's upstairs. Actually, I might as well open it up. I don't think I opened it up yet. And that was the key that we got from the second Bowser fight. Alright, you go up the stairs, and can open it. There's Wet Dry World right there. Some of these paintings are just paintings, like that one right there. I don't think he gives you anything. Yeah. There's another one here. Yeah, and he had one. Okay. Okay, that brings our total up to 75 now. We are just breezing through this game right now. Well, aside from some speed bumps, there was a Tall Tall Mountain, and then the room over there. There's like a door with like just an empty star on it. That one is Tiny Huge Island or whatever that's called. And Snowman's Land is right over here. You can see the reflection of a snow painting over there, but it's empty here. But this is how you get in. Alrighty. In the next video, we're going to start with Snowman's Land. Thanks for watching, everybody.